In Les Miserables, Victor Hugo presents to us an epic story of good versus evil, crime versus punishment, the power of grace and redemption. He convinces us that the outcasts, the miserables, are worth saving. He shows what change happens when grace is accepted. He demonstrates the power of love. The musical itself opened in London in 1985 and began on Broadway in 1987. With the staging and music, this timeless story has been portrayed to over 60 million people, translated into 22 languages, and performed in 44 countries. We hope this small rendition of some of the favorite selections from the musical encourages you to see the Broadway production or reminds you of the powerful emotions you felt seeing Les Miserables.
Jean Valjean, a peasant, was arrested for stealing a loaf of bread to feed his sister's child. On a chain gang for 19 years, prisoner 24601 finally is released by Inspector Javert. He must remain on parole for the rest of his life, doomed to live as an outcast. Fortunately, he meets the Bishop of Digne, who treats him with grace, even after Valjean steals his silver. Instead of condemning him, the bishop gives him silver candlesticks as well, showing Jean Valjean the power of forgiveness. He encourages Jean Valjean to become an honest man, for God has raised him out of darkness. With this, Valjean realizes his life is worth and vows to start afresh. Changing his name and breaking parole, he becomes Monsieur Madeleine, a factory owner mayor within 8 years of his release. Beautiful Fantine, one of his many employees, has an illegitimate daughter, Cosette. Once the other employees find this out, they demand her firing, which the foreman, whose learned advances has been spurned, is delighted to do. Suddenly, Fantine finds herself penniless and unable to spend money to the deceitful guardians of her daughter, Cosette.
Soft.
Fontaine sells her hair cheap and eventually herself and becomes ill with tuberculosis. Valjean hears of the injustice done to Fontaine. He sends her to a hospital with hope that she recovers. Meanwhile, Javert begins to suspect that Monsieur Madeleine is Jean Valjean. He writes to Paris, but learns that another man has been arrested. Knowing that an innocent man has been captured in his place presents a quandary to the noble Valjean.
Fallen from power.
While walking the streets of Paris, Marius Pontmercy, a young student, sees and falls in love with the lovely Cosette. Marius asks Eponine, now grown up as well, to find Cosette's house. Unbeknownst to Marius, Eponine, who he sees as merely a friend, is in love.
Everyone that says is a dagger in me.
letters and decides to go to the barricade in the hopes of saving Marius. Eponine cannot stay away from her beloved Marius and returns, only to be shot.
Thank you. Thank you.